We want to find the infinite sum of the geometric sequence, if it exists, when a sub 1, the first term, is equal to 24, and r, the common ratio, is equal to 3/4. We are able to find the infinite sum of a geometric sequence if the absolute value of r is less than 1. So if it doesn't meet this condition, then the infinite sum will not exist. And since we're given r equals 3/4, we can find this infinite sum. The infinite sum is equal to a sub 1, the first term, which is 24, divided by 1 minus r, or 1 minus 3/4. So it is pretty amazing that we can find an infinite sum with a formula that's less involved than the formula for a partial sum of a geometric series. Here we would have 24 divided by 1 minus 3/4. Well, 1 is equal to 4/4. So 4/4 minus 3/4 is 1/4. Well, 24 divided by 1/4 is the same as 24 times the reciprocal of 1/4, which would be 4 over 1, or just 4. 24 times 4 is equal to 96. So our infinite sum is equal to 96. Let's go ahead and show several of the terms in this sum so we can get a better idea of what this means. We know our first term is 24. Plus, to find the next term in the geometric series, we would multiply by 3/4. 24 times 3/4 is equal to 18. So now we'll keep multiplying by 3/4 to find the next several terms. So 18 times 3/4 is equal to 27/2, which is the same as 13.5. Let's go ahead and find one more term. 27/2 times 3/4 would be 10.125, or 81/8. And again, this is an infinite series, so it goes on forever. And the sum of this infinite geometric series would be 96. Let's look at one more example while we're here. It's the same question, but now the first term a sub 1 is equal to 2, and the common ratio r is equal to 3. This problem just emphasizes that in order to find the sum of an infinite geometric sequence, the absolute value of r must be less than 1, and since the value of r is equal to 3, this infinite sum does not exist. And again, let's go ahead and illustrate this by finding several of the terms in this series. The first term is 2. And then because the common ratio is equal to 3, to find the next term, we'll multiply by 3. 2 times 3 is 6. Multiply by 3 again. 6 times 3 is 18. Multiply by 3 again. 18 times 3 is equal to 54. And so on. Well, we can easily see now that these terms are getting larger and larger, and therefore this infinite sum is approaching positive infinity, which is the reason why this infinite sum does not exist. We'll take a look at one more example in the next video. I hope you found this helpful.